Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we'll use geometric shapes, measures, and their properties to describe real-life objects. Let us understand it with the help of an illustration. Let us take an example of a tree trunk. Now, here we are given a tree trunk, and we have to identify its shape. For this, we see what shape do we get when we cut this trunk horizontally. Now, when we cut it by a plane horizontally, we get a circular cross section. Also, we see that there are no edges and there are two circular bases. Now let us draw its geometrical shape. So here we have two circular bases and a curved surface. So we can say that it is a cylinder. So whenever we have to model a tree, we take a circular base and draw a cylindrical shape. And if we are given radius and height of a tree, we can find its volume and surface area using the formula of volume of cylinder and surface area of a cylinder. Now let us take another example. Here we are given two tents and we want to identify their shapes. Now in the first figure, we see that tent will have triangular cross section. And it has 5 faces, 6 corners and 9 edges. So, this tent is a triangular prism. Now, in the second tent, we can see that there are no sharp edges. And here we can see that the base is a circle and the vertex just lie above the center of the base. So it will have circular cross section. So, it is a cone. So, when we model a conical tent, we will have a circular base whose radius will give us radius of circle and height of cone will give height of tent. And when we are given radius, height, slant height of a conical tent, we can find its volume and area using formulas of volume of cone and surface area of cone. So in this session, we have learned how to use geometric shapes, measures and their properties to describe real life objects. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.